Hello everyone, I'm Vaishali and this is the first lesson from my course Falling In With Amino Acids, in which I'm going to talk about glycine. So first of all, if we can introduce glycine in very brief, then it is the amino acid which is necessary for our central nervous system, which means our brain and healthy prostate. Now prostate is a gland which is present in males, and this gland has a very important function if we talk about the male reproductive system. So glycine is the amino acid which deals with the healthy prostate or health of the prostate gland. So if anybody or any male is rich in glycine or has a proper content of glycine, then you can say that the reproductive health will be very good. Now if we talk about the structure of glycine, then glycine is the amino acid which have a single hydrogen atom as its side chain, and it is the simplest possible amino acid. It is the smallest one in size and also the simplest one. Now the chemical formula is given here, and glycine is one of the, you can say, proteinogenic amino acids, which is meant as the protein forming or protein making amino acid, and it has the codons. These four codons code for glycines. Now glycine is a colorless, sweet tasting crystalline solid, and it is unique among all of the amino acid as it is a chiral. This is the only amino acid which is a chiral. Now what does a chiral mean? If a carbon atom or the central carbon atom, which have four other attached groups or moieties, have different four moieties, like in case here you can see one moiety is the carboxylic group, another moiety is the amino group. Now these two moieties are same in case of glycine, which is two hydrogen atoms. So if one carbon supposedly is attached to four different groups, then it is known as the chiral amino acid or chiral carbon. Now this amino acid is a chiral because carbon A, which is the central carbon in this amino acid, is attached to two of the same groups, which is the hydrogen atoms. So that's why it is a chiral. A chirals are the molecules which are not able to rotate the plane of plane polarized light. So that's why they are called as the chiral molecules. So this is one of the chiral molecules, and besides this, it can exist in the deuterion at natural pH, and it can fit into both hydrophilic or you can say hydrophobic environment as it exists as the deuterion. And this is what you can say the molecular structure of glycine, how glycine looks like. Now if we talk about the discovery of glycine, then this was the person. Henry Braconnot first discovered glycine in 1820. And if we talk about the industrial manufacture, as glycine is one of the important industrially used amino acid, then it is manufactured by using chloroacetic acid along with the ammonia. And this is the glycine moiety which is synthesized, and people synthesize glycine using this way from a long back, and they can synthesize like 15 million kgs annually. So you can say that this is the very popular, well-known, and you can say successful method to synthesize glycine. Besides this, if we talk about the acid-base property of the glycine structure, then in aqueous solution, glycine itself is amphoteric, meaning that it can act as both acid as well as base. If we talk about the low pH, at low pH, this molecule can be protonated, and you can see here the positively charged glycinium cation, so it is protonated. And if we talk about the neutral pH, it acts as a deuterion, that is, it contains both positively and negatively charged groups. And if we talk about the high pH, or you can say the low acidity, then it has an anionic group, which is this group. So at low pH, you can say it donates the protons, and at high pH, you can say that it accepts the protons. Protons are nothing but hydrogen ions here. So the nature of glycine in aqueous solution have been investigated by various theoretical methods. And in the solution, the ratio of concentration of the two isomers, which is this and this, is independent of both the concentration and the pH, and the ratio is simply the equilibrium between two of them. This is the equilibrium. So this is what acid-base properties of glycine looks like. Now if we talk about the sources of glycine, or you can say what are the sources or popular meanings by which we can gain or we can eat glycine, then if we talk about the non-vegetarian sources, they are mainly fish, dairy products, meat and cheese. And while in plant sources, we can see beans, you can say soybeans, spinach, pumpkin seeds, then kale, cabbage, cauliflower and cucumber and kiwi also. So these are all the sources of plants or vegetarian sources which anyone can have to have a rich, or you can say good source of glycine in order to be healthy. I have a healthy nervous system. And glycine is a non-essential amino acid so that it is synthesized inside our body. And it is manufactured inside our body mainly in liver. So it does not have to obtain directly through the diet. But even though if we have a rush of glycine or we need a glycine immediately, glycine moiety, then we can have these sources. Now the uses include as an additive in pet food and animal food, also as a sweetener, and sometimes used to certain food supplements and protein drinks also. And various drug formulations also use this substance, you can say glycine, for better absorption in the intestinal region. So thank you guys, this was all about the glycine. You can follow it and share for the recent updates by me on Academy. Thanks.